Hello everyone, I'm back with another Plug It In and Play TV Games mini review. I'm sorry I've been on YouTube lately. I haven't had access to my computer, but I will get it back this Sunday. So what's the controller today I'm going to be reviewing? PlayPal, Plug and Play. Again, it's by AT Games, released in 2006. It takes two AA batteries. Fortunately, there's no screw. It just has a tab. A joystick. It has a Sonic. It has a multi Sonic the Hedgehog. It has a fist. A B buttons. Start. Reset. On off. Has 28-bit Sega games in one. Oh yeah, that's basically it. It's powered on. And it was sold on HSN 3 times. Okay. 20 games built in. The first game is Sonic Blast. Sega. The music is way too high. The music and sounds got high-pitched. On this controller, the originals are much better, and it's not high pitch. The originals are not high pitched. This is but the Master System hardware is high pitched. Like a noob. If I don't play it like a noob, I fail at Sonic. I played Sonic Drift 1, but I never played Sonic Drift 2. I Spin ball. The Game Gear version, everybody hates it, but I like it. Triple. I never played this one before. Mega! Kid games. I'll skin High Tech World. For the Master System games, it says push start button. You don't press start, you have to press the A button. lost stars. This game is ridiculously hard.
I'm the miracle
ball. Okay, the audio quality sounds really bad. It's ridiculously hard. I cannot beat the first level. That covers the Alex Kidd games. Altered Beast. I have this game on the Master System, but this game is. It's kind of high pitched, and people say it's a bad version. But it's not a good one. Blaster Boy. Sorry, Blaster Boy just entered the building. Astro Warrior. It seems like Star Force clone. Bomber Raid. This game is to be originally released by Activision. Look here, let's make us say that. Next. It's an okay port of the Genesis version. I did play this version on Sonic's collection, plus on the PS2, I guess.